Hello, welcome to our channel Elimika Mtandaoni. My name is Agustino Mogosi. Today we are in the second lecture on information technology. In this lecture we'll be talking about categories of computers. So let us start with the introduction. Actually, when people think of computers, actually they think of some things like the laptop or the office computer that you have on your desk there, and the only thinking that they have is all those two only are computers. But actually, computers are all around us and can be broken down into separate categories depending on their size and processing power. So what are the real categories of computers? Actually, there are five main categories of computers. The first is supercomputers. We have supercomputers, we have mainframe computers, we have mini computers, we have microcomputers and mobile computers. So these are the main categories of computers in this world. Let us start with supercomputers. What are supercomputers? The term supercomputer is used to describe computers that have the most capable processing power of its time. So when we are talking about processing power, it means that the time it takes to process certain data within a particular time. These supercomputers are high capacity machines with thousands of processors that can perform more than several trillions calculations per second. I say several trillions calculations per second. As we know, the purpose of computers is to process data into information. So if that is the purpose of a computer, then that capacity of a computer to process trillions of calculations per second, then we call that computer a supercomputer. These are the most expensive and they are the most fastest computers available. Supers, as they are called, have been used for tasks that require processing of enormous volumes of data. These computers are normally used for things like sensors count. They are normally used for weather forecasting. They are used for designing aircrafts. They are used for modeling molecules and breaking encryption codes. So they have their uses in those areas. These supercomputers are still the most powerful computers, but a new generation may be coming, but that relies on nanotechnology, in which molecule-sized nanostructures are used to create tiny machines for holding data or performing tasks. So you may find supercomputers with a small size but high processing capacities. So in Tanzania here, we have a supercomputer at the Institute of Technology in Dar es Salaam. We have a supercomputer called the Param. We have a supercomputer called the Param Serengeti. Actually, this is a facility for education and research in various scientific fields. And the facility includes 20 terabytes of raw storage and 38 terabytes of tape backing along with the relevant backup software. And the areas where this Param Serengeti computer in Tanzania is used for, it is used for bioinformatics, it is used for atmospheric science, oceanography, or computational fluid dynamics. It is used for finite element analysis, seismic analysis, and materials modeling. Also, it has some data visualization tools. So at the Dar es Salaam Institute of Technology, there is one supercomputer. As you can see here in the diagram, it is like a field, it's like a cabinet, it's like a fridge, something like that. It's big in size, but it has trillions of processors in it. So that is one example of supercomputer. Another type of computers, we have what we call mainframe computers. Just like supercomputers, mainframe computers, they are also huge. They are huge, as you can see here. They are huge. They are towering machines. You find them like a tower. They are towering machines, but with a lot of processing power. The mainframe computers are mostly used by corporations. They are used by government agencies and banks. They are used by organizations that need a way to store large quantities of information. So these supercomputers actually store larger quantities of information. They are not the same as supercomputers, but the processing capabilities of these mainframe computers are used in millions of instructions per second. So as we talked about supercomputers that can do some trillions calculations per second, these ones can do millions of instructions per second. Supercomputers, on the other hand, are measured in floating point operations per second. So if you go to institutions like if you go to some institutions, some organizations that need to store large quantities of information, these institutions actually use the mainframe computers. And you will find that these mainframe computers, they have a kind of, they can be put in some cabinets. As you can see here, they can be put in some cabinets and a screen is connected to them an external user wants to do some things with that computer. As you can see here, you find it is connected to a screen, and the storage and other processing devices are found in these other parts of the mainframe computers. So that is another type of a computer that we call a mainframe computer. After we have discussed about mainframe computers, now let's talk about mini computers. Speaking of mini computers, a mini computer is a multi-processing machine. I say it's a multi-processing machine. It's a multi-processing machine that can support up to about 200 users. It can support to about 200 users. For example, you may find this is a mini computer here. And this can be connected to several other users with other computers. So you find other computers connected to this mini computer. Several other computers connected to this mini computer. So it can support to up to 200. It can support to up to 200 users. In fact, a server can be an example of mini computer. If you have ever heard of a server is a computer that provides services to other computers. So, so long as a mini computer can support up to about 200 users, then a server can be an example of mini computers. But not all servers are mini computers. Well, I say that a server can be a mini computer, but not all servers are mini computers. You have to take a note of that. But despite their names, a mini computer is not a personal computer like desktop machines or you might have it at home. It is just called a mini computer, but it can, it has a multiple processing capabilities. That is, they are much larger than the normal personal computers because of the ways these microcomputers have excelled in processing power even beyond mini computers. And at a much smaller size, mini computers have become pretty much obsolete, but many computers in size, they are as larger, much larger as compared to the micro computers that we are going to talk in a while. Now let's talk about microcomputers. Microcomputers are the ones that people are most familiar with on a daily non-professional basis. But of course, that does not mean they are exclusive to the home. These microcomputers are the ones that even normal people can have. They include computers like the desktop. They include computers like the laptops that we know. The microcomputers are smaller computers that run on a microprocessor in the central processing system. So they use microprocessors. They use microprocessors as compared to other types of computers that have several processors, multiple processors. These ones use microprocessors. Actually, microcomputers are smaller computers that run on microprocessors in the central processing units, and they are much, much cheaper than supercomputers. They are cheaper than mainframe computers. They are even cheaper than mini computers, because they are meant for everyday users that are more practical than professional. Microcomputers have they are of several types. These microcomputers, they are of several types. We can have desktop computers, we can have tower computers, and even notebooks computers. Now let us look at these microcomputers. We have what we call a desktop computer. A desktop computer actually is much older microcomputer. It has a case or a main housing that sits on top of a desk. If you have found a computer like this one, this one here. You find it with a screen like this, and its cabinet or its system unit can stay on top of a desk. These kinds of computers, we call them desktop computers. We have another kind of computers that we call them tower computers. They are microcomputers whose case sits as a tower, often on the floor beside a desktop. If you ever find a computer like this one here, it has this system unit, and it has a screen like this. So you find its screen is somewhere there. Its screen is like this, and the tower computer is beside it, or it is put down the desk. So it is like a tower. This one is called the tower computer. We have some computers that we call notebooks. We call notebooks. They are also called laptop computers. These are lightweight portable computers with a built-in monitor, with a built-in keyboard, hard drive, CD drive, battery, and AC adapter. They can be plugged onto an electrical outlet, and they weigh anywhere between 1.8 to 9 pounds. So if you ever found computers like this one, these ones are what we call notebooks. We have some other computers like these ones. They fall under netbooks. We will see. Now we have a special category for these computers. We call them mobile computers. We have also some personal digital assistants. These are handheld computers or palm tops. They combine personal organization tools, schedule planners, address books, to-do lists, with the ability in some cases to send email and faxes. So let's talk about mobile computers. As we have said, these are exactly what they sound like. Computers that are super small and mobile are called the mobile computers. You should argue that a desktop computer is mobile if you need it to be. But mobile computers usually describe computers that are meant to be carried around and taken from place to place. So if a desktop computer is a microcomputer, then a laptop is a mobile computer. So here is a list of devices that could be categorized as mobile computers. We have laptops also can fall under mobile computers. We have the netbooks, they can also fall under mobile computers. The tablets. So speaking of a laptop, as we have said, it's a portable computers designed to be carried from place to place. These netbooks are much smaller than laptops. We have tablets. These are the flat keyboardless screen that utilizes touch screen functionalities for navigation and use. We have handheld game console. Actually, these are devices like the Game Boy, the Game Boy Advance, the Sega, the Nomad PlayStation, the PlayStation Portable, PSP, and PlayStation Vista. All these fall under handheld game consoles. We have even calculators. These are the computers that carry out computers, most of the basic parts. We have portable media players, also known as MP3 players. These also fall under mobile computers. And we have cell phones or smartphones also fall under mobile computers. So your iPhone or your Samsung or your Tecno, Infinix, all these are also called the mobile computers. So that so far we have talked about the categories of computers, and in this lecture we have discussed the several categories, about five main categories. So thank you for following Elimika Mtandaoni. My name is Agustino Mogosi and this is Elimika Mtandaoni. Don't forget to subscribe.